Hello all, and welcome to episode 2 of A Foray Into My Childhood, sort of. This time, I'm going to be playing Addition and Subtraction 2. Let's see how it does. First there's a one-way, now there's train tracks? Is there a sort of a transportation theme going on here? There's an airplane. Travel through addition and subtraction 2. Same author, of course. As before, we have have 9 activities. Let's start with the first one, of course. Now for activity 1. Reminiscent of activity 1 of this addition and subtraction 1. A traffic light flashing green. I kind of thought it would pick up where the other one left off. I guess it's building on the other one. Going a little farther than addition and subtraction 1 on the number line. Yay, I filled in the number line from 0 to 10. Way to go! Planes, trains, and automobiles, huh? Here is activity 2. One, 11. From bars to cars. This has got to be easier in some other languages where the uh, words aren't that you get aren't practically inscrutable. In English, you just kind of have to memorize by rote, especially the early ones, right? 11, 12, 13's a little better. Sounded like an error noise, but it wasn't apparently. I guess I got them all right. I didn't hear any actual error noises. Crossing signs, or rather, well, signs that are actually at the crossing, not just one's warning of a railroad crossing ahead. Okay. Showing numbers that add up to 10. And which add up to numbers past 10. Very important. Because probably not particularly obvious to the target audience. That 8 and 8 is 16. Basically introducing the concept of that. No. I'm guessing that 10 is the lowest answer that will be provided here. I don't know if chance is doing this or they're deliberately giving me sums of 10. It's looking more like that. Likely that's the case. Skipped 12 amazingly, and then went back for it. Okay, got through that activity. We're one third of the way through. Approximately. Again, as in addition and subtraction 1, we're showing that it's the same answer regardless of how the question is formatted. Thank you. Okay, activity 4 is in the bin. And activity 5 is coming up. Apologies for any additional sounds you might hear. And now we're adding with more than three add-ins. More than two add-ins, rather. And also 7 and 6 is 13 and 2 is 15. If it's going to use 0 as an add-end or not. If not, then 3 is the lowest sum. All right. Way to go. You have finished activity 5. Here is activity 6. Now we're going to head these another way, vertically. New graphics, now we got the sun behind, partially behind a cloud. Any other reward images? Is this what you call railroad crossing? Anyway, it looks like we're subtracting. Where the subtrahend is 10 or greater. I don't know if they'll have a strip track tour. that's greater than that's 10 or greater, or if they'll have a difference that's 10 or greater. But I guess we shall see. And now we're subtracting vertically. When the subtrahend is 10 or greater. Going the long way around in case the bar is very tall. Thank you. know, it's curious. You never see the airplane in the actual activity. I guess we'll see if that continues to be true. We see the airplane here, introducing each activity and congratulating you on completing the last, but not as a reward image for the for getting an answer right. As you get answers right, the car moves along the road. On, I notice the left side of it and the sign keeps track of how many answers you got right. Making sure you notice the operation, the operator there. Wonder if at some point it's going to not flash the operator so that you have to notice that on your own. Thank you. Okay, way to go. Your score is 24 out of 24. Now try extra for experts. Missing at end. Oh? Is that part of this program? Sort of a pre-algebra-like thing going on here. Sound effect actually makes sense this time. It's almost like a Doppler effect thing. Or maybe that is exactly what it's trying to simulate. Well, that's it for this episode. I will see you next time.